So we're going to a pot of value, pelvic floor. How does it move? How does it come to stillness? What's its relationship to gravity? How does it come to stillness? It's a quality of its stillness. How does it seem? Move through space. Coming back. To the pulse. On the axis. Moving to Samana Vayu, the focus of attention now, like a field of focus on the energy pattern, filling the whole body, starting with its rhythm. Observing how it moves, past observation, found it flowing, fluid. Without breaks. So how does it stop without breaks? We figured or found. It has to have a balance of forces. And how do the eyes see? The next body, which is, we start at the bottom.
Yes, and that takes us to my favorite, Apana Vayu. My function in this quite often, so it's that anal pelvic floor.
Most dancers do like this one, it's max control. It also is the support.
Well, it seems like straight lines. As you know, they are no straight lines.
Except I question that, because if there's a tautness between Su-Feh and I, then is that not straight? And then if you let that tautness go, it becomes
kind of... But then there's a curve.
The eyes in a bottom way are very direct. Stillness is very rooted.
And when you work in this, of course, you know, it's impossible to be completely in one place.
Absolutely
body.
Impossible.
Not,
but this is why some of the pairings are so interesting, like the weightiness of
I think naturally you move from the values interconnected, of course. But as Karen said, when we spend time in these one values, it's like looking at the world through a...
So you can tell that swing and then suspend it totally.
Colored gel.
Yeah.
The gel of that value.
So Su-Feh's exercise is really interesting. We found.
Oh, this reminds me.
This subject.
of a push hand.
We are bringing them right in, aren't we?
Because the pranavayu is kind of this yielding passive weight center. And it reminded me of this exercise that I've done of practicing yielding and listening for the moment when the yield turns into a thrust.